The game everyone's been waiting for. Kent at Buffalo, Wednesday night football. I've waited,
Mac Madness.
I'm joking. But you know something? The limits on this are pretty much the same.
Primetime game.
Who do you like and why?
I'll tell you what. This total opened 54. It's now down as low as 51.5, 52. I think the early sharp money's on the right side. I really like the under in this game. Here's two teams where based on their final game, the last game before this one, their final score, they put up, the defense looks like it allowed a lot of points, and because of that, we're getting an inflated total. But these are teams that had 2 weeks to prepare, and I think that gives us an edge on defense.
Okay, so in general, 2 weeks to prepare is an edge for the defense.
When they have had a bad game, I think that's what you're going to focus more on. It's if the offense put up 500 yards of offense and you have 2 weeks to prepare, you're walking around with your chest out, your offense is
killing it. Plus, you've got the public reacting to the fact that they had 500 yards of offense.
But when your defense has allowed 30 and 40 points, I think that's what you're focusing on in practice.
All right, so it seems like with this line move, you're running into the classic paradox is when the line moves and it's clearly sharp action under on a total, it doesn't seem likely they're setting up a middle, that it looks like a true position as you call it. Now the question is this, is you know what the sharp's like, but you're playing at the second or even third number. How do you balance that? Because it's always, on one hand, what I often say is you don't want to bet on it.
Sure.
But you don't want to bet against it.
Sure.
Because it hasn't moved enough to make lane 110 the other way. But I also can think on a total, each half point means a little bit less. But usually you being a market reader and oftentimes playing at the second number, how do you decide when there's still value and how do you decide when the value's gone?
Personally, besides what you made your true line, obviously, but what I like to look at is it around a key number? We know when it comes to totals, 51 is the next really important number that if this one dipped under, I think a lot of the value would have been extracted. That's number one. Number two, I look at what signs the betting public gonna come in on, because if they're gonna come in against the wise guys, then I have a chance where maybe I could sit back and instead of piggybacking early, allow them to come in and maybe get this line back up for me where I could get almost as good as a number late as those guys got early.
Okay, so and maybe at the very end of this, you can tell us when you recommend playing this game. Last question on this. Yeah, when I did my basic handicap, I saw 539 yards were given up against Kentucky, and then Buffalo in the last 24 outings have given up an average of 31 points. So you're really going strongly against what anyone doing kind of a 15-minute handicap
Correct.
Is going to be looking over. Wise guys betting under. So is it really, it's pretty much that simple for you, right?
That, and I believe the way these teams set up. You have two teams that I think their defense is way ahead of their offense, even though those scores and those yardage that you touched on don't reflect it as much. And what I'm trying to say is this. You look at Kent, last year it was their defense that was good, and they returned 9 starters, and you got to remember they had a defensive coordinator that came from Illinois. He won 100 games at Illinois. I think it took a little while for them to really learn his system, and now they've had that extra 2 weeks to prepare. I think that's an advantage. And then on the Buffalo side, here's a team with absolutely no offense. They have no standout quarterback. They run the ball, and I don't think they'll be able to do that against Kent, and I think Kent's offense won't be able to do much against a Buffalo defense that also returned a lot from last year.
All right, we've talked it through. Let's make it official.
Kent at Buffalo, Thursday night primetime game. Going to go under 51.5, 52. Let the betting public get involved. Push this line back up. Wise guys went under. Don't let what happened 2 weeks ago fool you. Both teams have had 2 weeks to prepare. Extra focus has been put on the defense. I like this game to stay under the total.
You know, one of my sayings is always, the hardest bets to make are usually the best bets. Looking at these yardage numbers, looking at these scores.
It's a lock.
You're making it. It's a lock.
That's the case.
All right, guys. Don't say VR is not afraid to go against the grain. Remember, we're going to be doing the Thursday game, the Friday game, Saturday game, Sunday games, and the Monday game.
Football.
All at pregame.tv.